Greetings. Brother Salim, you asked a really good question, but I have changed your name to protect you. Hello, I came across your channel and saw some of your comments. May I ask, what is all the reasons you are against Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, and what is your definition of a prophet? I'm more than happy to answer your question, brother, and I've given you a more full answer here. Greetings, brother, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, the risen Son of God. I believe those who call themselves Muslim do so because they want to please the God who made heaven and earth, the God who made covenant with Abraham. If you study the history of the Torah and the Bible, brother, you will find that they are two halves of a whole message. The prophets of the Old Testament reveal the Son of God. Prophet David revealed the Son of God. Psalms 2:7, I will declare the decree the Lord has said unto me, Thou art my Son, this day have I begotten thee. Prophet Isaiah revealed the Son of God. Isaiah 9:6, For unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulder, and his name shall be called Wonderful, Counselor, the Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace. Prophet Solomon revealed the Son of God. Proverbs 34, Who has ascended up into heaven or descended? Who has gathered the wind in his fists? Who has bound the waters in a garment? Who has established all the ends of the earth? What is his name? And what is his son's name, if you can tell? And in the New Testament, God gives his son to come to earth and fulfill the message of the prophets. Prophet Isaiah revealed that God would come to the earth. Isaiah 40, verse 3. The voice of him that cries in the wilderness, Prepare ye the way of the Lord, make straight in the desert a highway for our God. And the word God there is Yahweh. So Prophet Isaiah revealed a voice would prepare a path for God. Notice Isaiah said Yahweh, brother, not a Razul, a prophet. Yahweh is Almighty God. And Prophet John, or Yahya, claimed he was the voice Isaiah foretold. Matthew 3:3, For this is he that was spoken of by the prophet Isaiah, saying, The voice of one crying in the wilderness, Prepare ye the way of the Lord, make his paths straight. Mark 1:3, The voice of one crying in the wilderness, Prepare ye the way of the Lord, make his paths straight. John did baptize in the wilderness and preached the baptism of repentance for the remission of sins. Luke 3:4, As it is written in the book of the words of Esaias the prophet, saying, The voice of one crying in the wilderness, Prepare ye the way of the Lord, make his paths straight. John 1:23, he said, I am the voice of one crying in the wilderness, make straight the way of the Lord, as said the prophet Isaiah. So of this, brother Salim, there can be no doubt. Yahya was the voice, the prophet that Isaiah foretold. And Yahya prepared the path for Jesus. Yahya announced Jesus. Yahya's mission was to announce God, brother, and Yahya announced Jesus. Then Jesus himself claimed to be God by the very words he used. John 10:30, I and my Father are one. John 17:5, And now, O Father, glorify thou me with your own self, with the glory which I had with you before the world was. There are many other fulfillments, Brother Salim, and I document them in other videos. The reason I am against Mohammed is that he is a false prophet, brother. His message contradicts the message of the prophets and the message brought by the Son of God. In fact, brother, there is one historical fact that Islam was created to deny. Surah 4, 157 attempts to claim that Jesus Christ was not killed as the Lamb of God. In fact, Surah 4, 157 claims Jesus was not even crucified. And the next lie of the Quran is blasphemy against Almighty God. The Quran claims that God lied to every human on earth and created a false appearance that Jesus died. My definition of a prophet is the same definition as that of the Torah and Bible, brother. And both condemn Mohammed as a false prophet. But God was not surprised, my friend. The God of Abraham is truly all-knowing and knew the future even from before the world was created. Revelation 3:8. Written in the book of life of the Lamb slain from the foundation of the world. You see, brother, the Word of God is clear, recording that Jesus existed with God before creation. John 17:5. And now, O Father, glorify you me with your own self, with the glory which I had with you before the world was. Please consider those words carefully, brother. Jesus prayed. Jesus said out loud with his own mouth that he was with the Father, with God, before the world was. Jesus shared God's glory with God, and Jesus remembered doing so. And I know Islam has taught you Jesus is a separate God, another God. And that is simply false, brother. Isaiah 42:8, I am Yahweh, that is my name. I will not give my glory to, or share my glory with, another, or my praise to idols. You see, brother, Prophet Isaiah has given God's message that God will not share his glory with another God. And somehow you have to think logically. How then could Jesus, a prophet, claim that Jesus had shared God's glory? I will not give my glory to or share my glory with another. The answer, brother, is in the gospel that Jesus brought. Jesus and God are one, united. Best regards, Brother Salim. I pray Almighty God speaks to your heart and guides you to himself. And what about you, my friend and viewer? Do you believe the message of the prophets? The Bible says that their message of prophecy is more sure. More sure than what, Texas? 2 Peter 1:17. For he, meaning Jesus, received from God the Father honor and glory. When there came such a voice to him from the excellent glory, this is my beloved Son, in whom I am well pleased. And this voice which came from heaven, we heard when we were with him in the holy mount. We have also a more sure word of prophecy, whereunto you do well that you take heed, as unto a light that shines in a dark place, until the day dawn and the day star arise in your hearts. In the context, Peter is saying, the prophecy of the Old Testament that Jesus fulfilled is a more sure sign than God speaking from a cloud. Make sure you know the more sure prophecies that prove Jesus is the Son of God. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to his Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.